In this graph, we want to compare fetal hemoglobin with adult hemoglobin. In fact, humans express two different isoforms for hemoglobin through their lifespans. As a fetus, there is a fetal version of hemoglobin generated and expressed within the bloodstream pre-birth. This hemoglobin is very similar in structure to the adult version, but tends to have a slightly higher affinity for oxygen, as indicated by the left-shifted green curve here. The fetal hemoglobin is replaced with adult hemoglobin post-birth and is essentially fully replaced by about 6 months of life. We note that the adult hemoglobin isoform has a lower affinity, as indicated by the rightward shifted curve. This is indicated and standardized through use of the P50 value. P50 is the partial pressure of oxygen at which our hemoglobin is 50% saturated. As we can see, our fetal hemoglobin reaches 50% saturation at a lower partial pressure of oxygen than our adult hemoglobin. This indicates a higher affinity. Now, that's actually critical to the exchange of oxygen at the placenta, because the fetus derives its oxygen from the maternal blood. The fetus sends blood flow to the placenta. The mother sends blood flow to the placenta. Those two blood flows do not mix, but they flow adjacent to one another such that diffusive exchange of oxygen, carbon dioxide, nutrients, and waste can occur. So it's essential that the fetal hemoglobin have higher affinity, as it must gain oxygen from the maternal hemoglobin, which is giving up that oxygen. If we pick a partial pressure of oxygen at the placenta, 30 is a relatively common value for placental PO2. And if we go upward here, we can see that our maternal hemoglobin would be about 60% saturated at that partial pressure of oxygen, meaning it's given up about 40%, desaturated about 40% of the oxygen it was carrying. If we continue upward, though, we see that the fetus is well above 80% saturated. In other words, it is gaining the oxygen that the maternal hemoglobin is giving up. Now, this difference isn't enormous. We prefer to see the fetal hemoglobin much higher saturation than this, and that's actually possible due to a shift in affinity that occurs at the placenta. And we'll see more of this later in a later figure. But in short, the fetus gives up carbon dioxide, and this causes a shift to the left of its curve, right, indicating a higher affinity due to the loss of that carbon dioxide. The maternal blood picks up that carbon dioxide. This would cause a rightward shift, right, and a decrease in affinity. And now if we look at that same partial pressure of oxygen, about 30 here, right, now we see that we're generating a larger difference between the fetal and the maternal blood, right? The bigger the desaturation of the adult hemoglobin and the higher percent saturation of the fetal hemoglobin, the better oxygenation we have of the fetal blood to maintain aerobic respiration, growth, and development of that fetus.